Wilma Rudolph, from polio tragedy to triumphing as an Olympic champion.
Poliomyelitis, also known as polio, is a disease which can be caused by three different types of the polio virus. It is easily spread from person to person, mainly through water. It normally affects those under the age of 5. The symptoms of this disease can include damage to the brain and spinal cord, or in the worst cases, paralysis.
People with paralysis may have to use leg braces or wheelchairs to function in their daily lives. Unfortunately, others are required to use the iron lung. The iron lung is necessary to those that have paralyzed chest muscles, which makes them unable to breathe. The first polio outbreak happened in Vermont of 1894. This disease later fell upon the entire United States, resulting in an epidemic outbreak. There are two types of vaccines for polio, one given by injection and one given by mouth. Jonas Salk created the injected polio vaccine in 1955. The oral vaccine was developed by Albert Sabin in 1961. 99% of polio cases have decreased since it first started. However, we currently have three countries remaining with polio: Afghanistan, Nigeria, and Pakistan. Peg Corrette describes her life with polio in the book Small Steps, The Year I Got Polio. She explains in her book the thoughts she had of this disease. Polio. Panic shot through me, and I began to cry. I didn't want to get polio. I didn't want to leave my family and go to a hospital 100 miles from home.
Paul Alexander is a polio survivor who spends nearly all day, every day, inside his iron lung at home in Dallas, Texas. The disease paralyzed Paul from the neck down, so the machine helps him breathe by using negative pressure to force his body to take in air. He was only 6 years old when he caught polio in 1952, one of the worst outbreak years in U.S. history.
When I first contracted polio, I was just a kid like everybody else, but it began to feel a little bit
Wilma Rudolph was born 2 months premature on June 23, 1940. As a child, Wilma Rudolph tragically suffered from three life-threatening diseases. Double pneumonia left her unable to breathe at times and was fatal. She developed scarlet fever and had red rashes over her entire body. Wilma Rudolph received polio at the age of 4, leaving her left foot and leg immobile. For the next couple of years, she wore a brace and could not walk without the use of it. Many hospitals refused to treat the polio due to the fact that she was African American. Every single day, her brothers and sisters would take turns massaging Wilma's leg so that she would be able to walk again. Her mother drove her to a hospital 50 miles from home, twice a week for 2 years. One of her most famous quotes are, "My doctor told me I would never walk again. My mother told me I would. I believed my mother." With the help of her family and some determination, Wilma Rudolph beat polio. She triumphantly received one bronze medal in the 1956 Summer Olympics and three consecutive gold medals in the 1960 Summer Olympics. Olympic Committee President Dr. Leroy Walker admired Wilma Rudolph for her successes and wondered how she could overcome her tragedies and make them triumphs. He said, "She is immortal. We'll know about Wilma Rudolph forever." Jesse Owens, another Olympic track and field star, stated in the Saturday Evening Post, "She is still willowy and beautiful, still the person the whole world fell in love with. Wilma Rudolph's courage and her triumph over her physical handicaps are among the most inspiring jewels in the crown of Olympic sports. I have been there in the 60s to see her. The lovely Lilith Gazelle will never be forgotten. She was speed and motion incarnate, the most beautiful image ever seen on track." She created the Wilma Rudolph Foundation in 1981, which helped children in local communities become athletes. She wanted children to know how much they could succeed in their lives. In doing so, she quickly became one of the greatest, most empowering athletes to women, African American, and children in the 20th century. After winning in the Olympics, Wilma Rudolph returned to the place where she grew up, Clarksville, Tennessee. She was praised and idolized by many people. The townsmen and women wanted to celebrate her achievement by hosting a parade. However, at the time, people were still racially segregated. Originally, there was going to be two parades, one for the whites and one for the blacks. Wilma Rudolph refused to hold a parade if the community was not going to be as one group. Therefore, they held the first ever racially integrated event in the town of Clarksville, Tennessee. This sparked a major change in the history of blacks and whites. Wilma Rudolph also participated in a protest as a civil rights activist against the restaurant Shoney's, which only allowed white people to eat in it. Wilma Rudolph motivated women all over the world, especially those that also faced obstacles on their way to reaching their goals. One famous athlete that was motivated by Wilma Rudolph was Florence Griffith Joyner. Similar to Wilma, she won 3 gold medals in one Olympic game. Wilma Rudolph stated, "It was a great thrill for me to see. I thought I'd never get to see that." Florence Griffith Joyner, every time she ran, I ran.
I grew up a lot different from most kids. I grew up with a series of childhood illnesses. The beginning for me was scarlet fever, pneumonia, and the end result was polio. And I wore braces until I was 9 years old. I think the most difficult moments growing up was being teased by my peers and not being accepted to play and do all the things that one wants to do growing up.
After Wilma Rudolph retired from running in the Olympics, she went to go teach and coach students at a community center for the team, DePaul Tigers. Wilma Rudolph was recognized for her actions and awarded for her achievements. In 1960, she was entitled as the United Press Athlete of the Year. She was also known as the Associated Press Women Athlete of the Year in 1960 and 1961. Wilma Rudolph received the James E. Sullivan Award as a high honor for an athlete. She was entered into the National Black Sports International Hall of Fame and National Track and Field Hall of Fame. In honor of being one of the greatest athletes in the world, she was inducted into the United States Olympic Hall of Fame in 1983. In addition, she was awarded the National Sports Award and inducted into the National Women's Hall of Fame. She also inspired the Wilma Rudolph Courage Award and was given a statue from the city of Clarksville as an honor for being a great hero. She was honored by the Postal Service and featured on a stamp. Furthermore, Wilma Rudolph was invited to the White House by John F. Kennedy for being an influential Olympic runner and making great changes in history. Wilma Rudolph wrote an autobiography and participated in a film, both titled Wilma. Sadly, she died on November 12, 1994, from brain tumor. She will be remembered for her legacy and will live on in our hearts forever.
You were running a relay. We were behind when we started off. And you always think on a stagger start, and you know on a stagger start that, okay, she's going to catch her in the turn, and by the time the baton is passed, we are going to be even. Well, that didn't happen. And then when they pass it the next time, I said, well, by the time they get to the next person, we will be even, or we will be one step ahead. It didn't happen. And by the time it got to me, I saw that we were behind. And I made myself a promise that day. I said, if you catch the Russian, it's history, retire. If you do not catch the Russian, you will have to run another 4 years for the Olympics in Tokyo, Japan. I caught the Russian. I retired, it became history. It was the fastest single race that I'd ever ran in the history of my career. And to get a standing ovation in my own country, outdoors, which I'd never had before, I think was the grandest moment in my career. I retired that day, and I have never regretted it.